Introducing first, the team of the NXT Tag Team Champions, Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly. The NXT North American Champion, Roderick Strong. And the NXT Champion, Adam Cole. The Undisputed Era.
It has been a November to remember for the Undisputed Era, especially their captain, Adam Cole, who defeated Dominik Dijakovic in a ladder match to secure the advantage here tonight. And the Undisputed Era have been involved in, well, all three men's WarGames matches. They are 1-1, but here tonight, draped in gold, Adam Cole. From the beginning of the month, November 1st, where he faced Daniel Bryan at SmackDown to facing Seth Rollins on Raw, to what the Undisputed Era did last night on SmackDown. I mean, across all three brands, has anyone had a better month than Adam Cole, baby?
I don't think there is anybody who can say they had, but now it's about tonight. Who has the best night at TakeOver WarGames?
And their opponents, first, from Wichita Falls, Texas, weighing at 340 pounds, Keith Lee!
Keith Lee has been calling himself the first of his kind, and his performances as of late have proved just that. What an unbelievable athlete, and what an asset to Team Ciampa Keith Lee is.
Here in Chicago, you don't want no problem with Lee.
Incredible, massive athlete who flies like a man 100 pounds lighter than him. Speaking of which.
Next, from Worcester, Massachusetts, weighing at 270 pounds, Dominik Dijakovic!
Dominik Dijakovic and Keith Lee with a thrilling series of matches that really defied everything. Two men their size doing what they're able to do in the squared circle. They have put their rivalry on the back burner. They are loyal to the soil. They are here now to try to secure victory for Team Ciampa. Dijakovic, of course, battled Cole in that ladder match to determine who would secure the advantage tonight, and he is staring daggers at Cole. It was here in Chicago where Tommaso Ciampa altered the trajectory of his career. And Daddy is indeed ready for war.
Painted up for a conflict, the light of which we perhaps have never seen before.
But it's not so full team ahead for Team Ciampa. Remember, they are one man short. Ciampa mentioned that they had asked someone to be a part of the team. That person is here, but we don't know if he jumped. Oh, Ciampa marching his way to the war game structure.
Well, no discussion, evidently.
He's the captain. He can do what he likes.
He's never intimidated by the odds.
Was gone for Undisputed Era. Going over strategy, Ciampa returning after being on the shelf for 7 months, following career-threatening neck surgery, relinquished the NXT title, and he's ready to get his hands on the UE.
What does this mean? Does this mean that there is no fourth member?
Yeah, I got it.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Get this, Roddy. Go get this, Roddy.
Oh, you're going to get it. You're going to get it.
NXT North American champion Roderick Strong, who will face AJ Styles and Shinsuke Nakamura in a triple threat at Survivor Series tomorrow. He has volunteered to get things started against Ciampa.
This great strategy, Strong has the best cardio of anyone on the Undisputed Era, perhaps anybody on the brand. So if you know someone's going to have a long time in this match, Strong's the guy to start.
Well, Yui's supposed to have the advantage, but Ciampa has the crutch.
Who's going to sit? I don't know if I'm Roderick Strong going in there without anything in my hands.
Well,
oh, wait. Oh, Strong is going to take advantage of this quote-unquote gift that Ciampa's given him.
What is this? What?
So it will be Strong against Ciampa first 5 minutes.
You think I need this to beat you?
Oh, Strong said, I don't need this to beat you. He just launched that crutch over the cage, and it's on. Ciampa and Strong beginning the proceedings here. Again, the first 5 minutes. And then the advantage begins for the Undisputed Era. The match doesn't officially begin until all, I want to say eight members, but right now Team Ciampa has only three.
And this match is fast and furious right from the start.
I mean, is Ciampa that confident to go into battle with the most dominant faction in NXT history, the Undisputed Era?
I'm not sure what's going on with Ciampa's mindset right now.
Well, last night, SmackDown became DXT, and of course, DX, NWO, Four Horsemen, all Hall of Fame factions. But the Undisputed Era are large and in charge, and Strong is taking it to Ciampa here tonight.
Strong is leading the charge to Tommaso Ciampa. You have to admire Strong for throwing the crutch to the outside. I think Strong realized that if it came down to weapons, perhaps that would give Ciampa the advantage. Just a traditional wrestling match, Strong wins.
Ciampa's so unpredictable, so reckless. A weapon in his hands is quite dangerous.
I don't want to take anything away from the match, but can we get confirmation that it is going to be 4-on-3? Is that what's happening here? Ciampa dropping Strong out over the top rope, and Ciampa kicking Strong right in the mush.
We talk about the motivation, the drive of Tommaso Ciampa. Undisputed Era looking on in shock that Roderick Strong is getting his dues paid right now.
Got to be hard for your team members to be in that cage now. You can't do anything to help your teammates.
It was here in Chicago a couple years back where Ciampa turned on his longtime partner, Johnny Gargano, beginning one of the most epic rivalries in WWE history. Gargano put on the sidelines by Finn Balor, and Ciampa here now. Raining down those right hands to Roderick Strong, Tommaso Ciampa, and Fuego!
And a clear message sent to Undisputed Era, courtesy of the Psycho Killer.
Ciampa better make the most of this advantage, because very shortly now, Roderick Strong will be joined by another member of the Undisputed Era. And you'd have to think Undisputed Era are favorites in this match, not just for the order of advantage.
And Beth, you mentioned the Psycho Killer. Ciampa tweeted that Chicago does, of course, hold a special place in his heart, and tonight we would see the return of the Psycho Killer. But right now, Roderick Strong, corner mount, raining down those right hands. Good escape by Ciampa.
Tommaso Ciampa certainly cut from the
What a kick by Ciampa!
Lights out for Roderick Strong.
Out like a light. Hey, like a light!
Well, the Undisputed Era certainly not looking too happy there in the cage. You can understand why. Roderick Strong hasn't done bed so well at the beginning of this match.
Ciampa looking for a draping DDT. Fought off by Strong. They're now in that middle section, and Ciampa lights up Strong. Strong counters with the right hand as these two warriors tearing into each other.
Get an awkward space, that strip of steel connecting the two.
What a clothesline by Ciampa. And again, first 5 minutes, one-on-one, and then the advantage begins for the Undisputed Era. Every 3 minutes, another member of each squad joins. And if it stands as it is now, it's going to be 4-3 when WarGames officially begins. Advantage, Undisputed Era.
Oh, wait a second, could be looking for the fairy tale ending.
It won't matter.
It would certainly give him an advantage, though. Could take out Strong here. Be ready to go one-on-one. But instead, the double knees, gut buster.
There he is.
And strong and Ciampa, that's all they can do is tear each other apart. Pinfall submissions do not matter until the War Games match officially begins. Strong with the ground and pound. Ciampa doing a good job of blocking a lot of those strikes.
Now the benefit of that cardio that I mentioned earlier. Strong absorbing a lot of punishment early in this first 5 minute segment. And now is still primed to attack.
Ciampa's such a resilient competitor, but when we talk about what he did to get here, coming back from neck surgery in record time.
All right, we're about to find out the next member of the Undisputed Era to come and help Roderick Strong to bolster their hopes here against Tommaso Ciampa.
Who's it gonna be?
And it looks like Kyle O'Reilly's bursting out of the cage, the only person in NXT history
O'Reilly
to hold three NXT tag team titles with three different partners. Strong, Fish, and Cole, and Ciampa trying to fight him off, but O'Reilly changes levels. Takedown, ground and pound.
O'Reilly, one of the most cable proficient grapplers in UE or even entire gold, red and gold. But hold on a second.
Oh, what a forearm by Ciampa. But look at O'Reilly continue to mix up his attack. Wow, sweeping the legs, and it doesn't matter what point he uses. The eight limbs, the Muay Thai decree is all about Kyle O'Reilly.
And that frantic attack giving Roderick Strong the opportunity to recover from earlier damage done. Now we're in a two-on-one situation.
The two guys that know each other very well. They've held the NXT tag team titles, of course. The Undisputed Era, the only three-time tag team champs, the current champs. And they will be involved in a triple threat tag team match at Survivor Series against the New Day and the Viking Warriors. That'll be Strong, or excuse me, O'Reilly and Fish.
But the Undisputed Era have to push their advantages now when they have this three-minute segment with a two-on-one advantage. They've got to make the most of it.
And again, Ciampa returning in miraculous fashion from surgically repaired neck has definitely put himself in the line of fire. The captain of his team, the man who marched to the cage with purpose. No discussion as to who was going to start this matchup.
You gotta think if you're Tommaso Ciampa, you've got two opponents now who are expending considerable amount of energy while he has two massive teammates completely fresh.
And Ciampa fighting off both Strong and O'Reilly, doing whatever he can to try to stay in this match. Gets neutralized by O'Reilly and now gets tagged by Roderick Strong repeatedly.
Nice forearms right across the side of the jaw.
It's hard to watch.
And the conditioning of Roderick Strong, second to none. And the Messiah of the backbreaker with a backbreaker. O'Reilly launches himself off the corner and drops the knee to Tommaso Ciampa.
Just see how well Undisputed Era members work together like a well-oiled machine.
O'Reilly said he wants to prove the Undisputed Era is more than a catchphrase and a hand gesture. They are doing a pretty good job thus far.
Undisputed Era talked about the fact that War Games was created here in NXT to end the era. But they won the first War Games and they would like to bounce back after tasting defeat at last year's War Games match. And so far, Strong and O'Reilly doing a good job of neutralizing Ciampa. But Ciampa will have some assistance in 1 second. And it will come in the form of Dominik Dijakovic.
This towering Croatian. We've seen this man do absolutely extraordinary things for a man his size. He will have to do an extraordinary showing against two members of the Undisputed Era here.
O'Reilly taking it to Dijakovic, but runs right into the big boot, and there's a forearm by Dijakovic.
We've seen Dijakovic clean house on Undisputed Era before.
Dijakovic was the one who mentioned that the art of war by Sun Tzu believed that the element of surprise was crucial to victory in conflict. Maybe he knows something we don't when it comes to the fourth member, if there is one, for Team Ciampa.
Wow, just this offense from Dijakovic. Clubbing down, look at O'Reilly, he's out on his feet.
Dijakovic proving size matters here as he is taking it to both Kyle O'Reilly and Roderick Strong, allowing Tommaso Ciampa to lick his wounds. Wow! Dijakovic just launched O'Reilly on top of Strong. And look, are we going to, is he going to give the fans a chance to feast their eyes? No, Roderick Strong will have none of it.
Uh-oh.
Oh, wow.
He's just angered Dijakovic. Oh!
Face first into the unforgiving steel cage, and again.
There's no good way to hit a steel cage.
Leaping into the guillotine there. O'Reilly trying to break down Dijakovic, trying to cut down the walking redwood to size. Oh, but
Riley couldn't hold on to it.
My gosh, the strength of Dijakovic driving the knee in the back of O'Reilly.
Oh, awkwardly against the steel cage.
Dumping O'Reilly like a sack of spuds, and now Dijakovic stands alone. But I think not a bad strategy, as I said, from Tommaso Ciampa, going in first and allowing his two bigger teammates to conserve energy.
And Tommaso Ciampa's the captain, meeting out instructions here. And Ciampa now back into the fray. Dijakovic concentrating as an attack on O'Reilly. Ciampa going on the attack on Strong. It's 2-on-2 for now. Undisputed Era does have the advantage.
I think you'd argue, even though the odds weren't in their favor to begin with, it's Team Ciampa all the way at this moment.
We'll see what happens once another member of Undisputed Era comes in to give themselves the numbers advantage.
Dominik Dijakovic in his first takeover. Tommaso Ciampa coming back from a serious injury. The Undisputed Era know all about what it takes to win here in the War Games as, wow, Dijakovic using the ropes and O'Reilly's momentum to pulverize one half of the NXT Tag Team Champions.
O'Reilly hitting that strip of steel hard.
Oh, who's it going to be? Looks like
that. And it's the other half of the NXT Tag Team Champions.
Here we go, here
Bobby
we go.
Fish.
Here we go.
Fish is ready to go to war.
And Fish, the veteran of the Undisputed Era, highly tenured multi-tag team champion before coming here and shocking the system.
And he wastes little time. And tying up, Tommaso Ciampa ducks underneath the attack of Dijakovic, and Bobby Fish, a scientist of the mat game, just look at the way he's able to cut down Dijakovic.
Bobby Fish sent the message earlier, this is our house, you're just living in it.
Bobby Fish like a surgeon, just picking apart two opponents.
He's as precise as a diamond and definitely knows what he's doing when it comes to dishing out the Undisputed Era punishment. And there O'Reilly to his partner's rescue.
And no combination, down goes Dijakovic.
A total elimination there by the Undisputed Era. That's how they defeated the Revival in an instant classic. Watch on NXT this past Wednesday as the Messiah of the Backbreaker delivers one to Ciampa.
And we're seeing the pendulum swing in favor.
Oh, chasing the dragon there by the UE.
And now the benefit of the order of entry advantage in full display.
Yeah! We got this, Cole!
And Bobby Fish yelling to his team captain, Adam Cole, we got this, Cole. Keeping the captain motivated. Of course, Adam Cole now realizes that he will defend the NXT title against Pete Dunne tomorrow at Survivor Series, and yet he still has to go to war here tonight.
But his Undisputed Era teammates doing a great job for Adam Cole, who's completely rested at this juncture.
You can see how they've separated both members of Team Ciampa to divide and conquer.
No time to rest for Ciampa and Dijakovic. Wave after wave, the UE attacks.
Fish O'Reilly is strong, like a pack of wolves.
Feast your eyes, you dork.
We run this, Keith Lee!
Well, the Undisputed Era, they're poking that caged animal who's Keith Lee right now. They better be careful. They need to focus. They need to take advantage of their advantage.
Time is ticking, boys.
Of course, now with the Undisputed Era taking the advantage here. They have so much more experience. They've been in every one of the WarGames matches thus far.
And to think that it's incredible, the whole WarGames concept, that the match has yet to officially start. And look at all of the punishment, all the damage we've already seen as the clock begins to tick down to zero.
Time to bask in the glory.
Here comes Keith Lee, got into it with Braun Strowman on SmackDown last night. He's been opening eyes and blowing people's minds since coming to NXT. The eclectic and electric Keith Lee.
Like a derailed train, you better get out of the way.
Completely fresh Keith Lee now.
Oh, wow, leapfrogs both Fish and O'Reilly. Keith Lee wipes out both Fish and O'Reilly. Is that Keith Lee or Bruce Lee? Incredible!
The agility of this big man is something to behold, and wow! The impact of the double crossbody.
Oh man, 320 pounds! We can't say that enough. Look at the way Keith Lee is taking it to the Undisputed Era.
The Allstate Arena is on its feet. Basking in the glory of Keith Lee.
And evidence of one of those unique chants that the NXT Universe, comes up with.
O'Reilly comes to his partner's rescue, but then eats a knee from Lee. And wow, O'Reilly able to crawl through the legs. But all three members of the Undisputed Era, and it takes all three to finally take Lee off his feet.
You'd have to think that pack mentality would pay dividends at some point. Ciampa absorbed so much punishment early in the match.
And it's the ground and pound as all three members of the UE attacking Keith Lee. But here comes Tommaso Ciampa. Ciampa rising from the ashes and now firing off strikes. Trying to do his best to keep the Undisputed Era at bay, but the numbers just too much.
A surge of adrenaline from Tommaso Ciampa, but just not enough to defeat that 3-on-1 advantage. Wait a second.
Oh, Dijakovic deposits O'Reilly into the other ring. Two rings, two cages.
With both big men up on their feet, it's gonna be a challenge for Undisputed Era.
Scorched earth, no holds barred war. A maelstrom of mayhem.
Well, Lee and Dijakovic coming together now, an incredible rivalry for the ages. Trying to put it beside themselves.
Imagine what a team, well, they're a team tonight, but what a team they would make if they were able to put their rivalry aside permanently.
Fish with the sleeper hold on Lee, trying to put the big man down.
O'Reilly working on Dijakovic. Dijakovic comes back with a right hand.
Tremendous strategy from Bobby Fish. If he could put Keith Lee to sleep.
All right, the advantage again here, Undisputed Era. Their fourth and final member, the team captain, Mr. November, NXT champion, Adam Cole.
And look at Adam Cole, incredible. Takes a run at Roderick Strong, they've got an idea. Bad intentions.
And Cole is about to set the table for destruction.
The rest of Undisputed Era is right on the same page.
The crowd here in Chicago ready to dine on destruction as Cole gathers another table.
This does not bode well. This bodes.
Whoa, wait a second.
What's the idea here?
Remember the. And again, just to keep everyone up to speed here, the match doesn't officially start until all eight members are in the cage. And yet, we still don't know if Team Ciampa has a fourth member, but the match has to take place in the cage.
Well, strictly speaking, until we know there isn't going to be a fourth team member, as you said, Morrow, this match doesn't start. So that means they can take people to the outside, damage them there, put them back in the ring.
Well, it looks like they're just filling the cage with as many tables as possible. Adam Cole definitely has a devious plan. Thought this out because the tables continue to come from underneath the ring.
Well, the experience factor for Undisputed Era and WarGames coming into play here. They clearly had a plan coming into this.
We could see more tables than warriors inside this sinister structure. Oh, no, no. How many tables are underneath there? And Chicago crowd wanted tables. They're getting them, and then some.
Well, Yui have got to push that advantage now because they don't know for sure that there isn't a fourth member. Nobody can tell.
That's what I want to question. Why wouldn't Adam Cole? I get all these tables. Now Ciampa kicks at him, but Beth, they had an opportunity to really take it.
Oh!
And there you go! Be careful what you wish for!
Undisputed Era took a risk, and it did not pay dividends.
That was a terrible landing.
Adam Cole usually does not make mistakes. He made a huge one there.
Cole clearly set that table up on the outside to do some damage to one of Team Ciampa, but instead
he set himself up.
The back of the neck driven into that table.
Okay, the door is now closed. 4-on-3 advantage, Undisputed Era. We have not received any word that the match is officially going to begin like what we saw in the Women's War Games match and all of the controversy in that contest. So now it's Dijakovic, Lee, and Ciampa on one ring, Undisputed Era in the other.
Team Ciampa the only one standing. Stalking their prey.
Yeah.
Wow, Yui retreating.
Waiting for a little bit of a respite.
There's nowhere to go, guys.
They're choosing perhaps their offense. We'll see.
This could be the last stand for Team Ciampa. 4-on-3, Yui, and it's on. It is on at TakeOver War Games.
And somehow, Team Ciampa able to maintain advantage despite a 4-on-3 numbers advantage.
He blew one man wrecking for what the? Wow! Attacking the peninsula south of the equator, and Keith Lee crumples to the canvas in a heap.
No disqualifications. Surprise, it didn't happen before now.
All right, well, the clock is ticking. It's official.
Submission.
Welcome back indeed. What a shock to the Undisputed Era system. Kevin Owens, Adam Cole colliding here at WarGames. Stunner by Owens. Owens goes for the cover. Oh, what an incredible night here in Chicago. And it just got even crazier with the arrival of Kevin Owens as the fourth member of Team Ciampa.
And what a reception here for Kevin Owens in the Allstate Arena.
He was involved in so many memorable NXT battles, a former NXT champion who has returned to the black and gold.
Oh no, this doesn't look good. Time to fly! Nasty landing, strung into Bobby Fish's right knee, I think. That was awkward. Oh, I hate to see that.
There's nothing non-awkward about being involved in this brutal match, the WarGames match, and Kevin Owens rattling the cage, lighting up the crowd in the Windy City. Chi-Town is en fuego.
The WarGames structure is so unpredictable. Anything else these superstars have been involved in.
Well, what an ace for Tommaso Ciampa.
Ciampa dripping DDT. Sends O'Reilly face first to the canvas. O'Reilly may be ripe for the picking.
All of the Undisputed Era is down. All of Team Ciampa is up with very bad intentions.
So much for the advantage, Undisputed Era.
Dijakovic having something in mind.
Cole attacking Owens. And the brouhaha continues to boil. So much potential for catastrophe.
Potential for damage, for injury. Matches like this shorten the man's career.
And the appearance of those tables making the double rings those that much smaller. Lending itself to that much more danger. Adam Cole trying to batter Kevin Owens. Dijakovic attacking strong.
Think of some of the incredible things we've seen at WarGames matches before.
You mentioned these matches shorten careers. They also give you nightmares for years to come.
Matches like this are where these warriors wish their bodies were made of the same material as smartphone screens. They are not unbreakable except for their fighting spirit. Ciampa head first into the cage courtesy of NXT champion Adam Cole, who remember has to survive this and then go on to Survivor Series to defend the NXT title against Pete Dunne. Oh wow, Kevin Owens, make that Keith Lee. Wait a minute. Oh my God! 320 pounds sailing through the air.
Hold on.
Kyle O'Reilly diving onto the leg, and now O'Reilly looking for the submission. Achilles tendon. Achilles locked by O'Reilly.
Smart to take off the legs of Keith Lee.
And of course, if Lee gets to the rope, it's no disqualifications. There won't be a break.
Right, and the referee's letting Lee know that.
All Lee can hope is that one of his team members comes to his aid.
And Dijakovic now looking to use the ring. Spring for the moonsault, Dijakovic on O'Reilly. This could be it. But Dijakovic goes for the cover. Bobby Fish, oh my God. Everyone pulling out each and every scintillating stomp, and Kevin Owens, no stranger to danger. Owens from the top turnbuckle. Swanton bomb.
Oh, that's it.
Covered by Ciampa. No. Cole with a kick to both Ciampa and Kevin Owens.
Adam Cole proving that in an alphabetical list of everyone in NXT, he is rightly at the very top.
He's also the only one standing at this moment.
Adam Cole doing his best to also go the high risk distance. Keith Lee struggling to get to his feet. Oh, and Lee launches his head into the midsection of Cole. And that forces Cole to drop down to the top turnbuckle.
Well, watch out. Cole stepping to the outside to try to get better leverage to prevent some offense.
TakeOver Chicago.
Oh, yes.
About to perhaps bask in Keith Lee's glory, but not if Roderick Strong has anything to say about it.
I mentioned earlier that incredible cardio of Roderick Strong. He has a second, a third, and a fourth win.
Oh, my God. Strong looking for the avalanche. Strong slam. Oh, wow.
Keith Lee struggling to get up.
UE double T, my God.
Lee goes down into the cover.
By O'Reilly. UE going to win now. Dijakovic comes to his rival's rescue.
The bond forged in battle. Wow, let's take a look at the strength of Roderick Strong, picking up over 320 pounds,
yeah, he just
crashing to the mat.
He just put the strong in Roderick Strong with that display of strength.
That high-low combination, not so awesome if you're Donovan Dijakovic.
Oh! Owens just launched Roderick Strong and now does the same, sending O'Reilly.
Oh no, the mat hurts!
Kevin Owens, the surprise fourth member of Team Ciampa. Remember the Undisputed Era attacking him Monday night on Raw. Triple H offering Kevin Owens an opportunity to return to NXT. Well, Owens has done it his way.
Wait a second. On that steel grate there between the two rings.
Cole struggling to pick the big man up.
And there is no honor in this ring. The War Games matches.
No.
Oh, my God.
No, 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 no.
Oh, with the package pile driver now. Owens.
Cole fighting with his might.
Oh, no. Cole in jeopardy. Adam Cole. Oh, he lands on his feet. Crossgate super kick by the NXT champion.
Oh, wait a second. You don't think. No way.
Oh, my God.
Panama.
Panama sunrise blocked by Adam Cole. Or make that Kevin Owens. Oh, wow. Oh, my God. Right in between the rings on that steel. Grid. Kevin Owens is out.
You can see the damage done to Adam Cole as well, the lower back and hips.
The ring littered with the carcasses of all eight warriors. And remember, in War Games, there are no victims, only volunteers.
You don't win War Games, you survive War Games. And right now, the question is, who will survive?
Great point, Nigel. We have Fish and Strong setting up, well, looks like more than one table.
Oh, this does not bode well for Team Ciampa.
I don't know if this bodes well for anyone in this type of match. And Strong targeting Tommaso Ciampa. Fish joining his UE brethren. It looks like they are targeting the team captain, wanting to make the statement, taking out the leader. But Ciampa valiantly fighting off the attack.
Nothing forgiving about those tables or the steel.
Tommaso Ciampa delivers a knee right to Kyle O'Reilly, was on the attack.
Hold on. Receive Ciampa. Project Ciampa knees to the back.
And what a knee. And another knee. Tommaso Ciampa picking up momentum.
Finding his fire.
His Team Ciampa on the verge of prevailing in War Games. Oh, super kick by the NXT champion. And Adam Cole has Ciampa. Ciampa, though, fighting it off. And Ciampa sends Cole into the cage. What else is going to happen in this wild War Games match?
Good Lord, this is just inhuman. and aggression.
You know who's smiling right now is Pete Dunne, watching Adam Cole eat those nasty knees from Tommaso Ciampa.
Look at all the carnage in the ring, the bodies laying on the floor. Competitors struggling to move.
Wait a second. Moving to the corner. Oh.
You are not safe in any area of the War Game structure. And Tommaso Ciampa now bringing NXT champion Adam Cole up to the top turnbuckle with him.
Whoa, took a quick look over his shoulder.
There's
oh my God.
Precarious position here. The two tables. Foreboding pieces of furniture.
Oh, watch out.
No way.
Sunset bomb.
No way.
You can hear the rattling of the steel.
Tommaso Ciampa and Adam Cole desperately struggling for superiority in the corner. The rest of the bodies still littering the cage. Actually, Keith Lee being lifted. Oh, wow, he's got his beard.
Oh, using the beard to his advantage. And now, as this match continues,
surveying the landscape. Oh, wow, wait a minute, Adam Cole. Adam Cole's gone all the way to the top of the cage.
Oh, we've seen Cole before ascend to the top of the cage and then try perhaps to send his opponent to the outside and win by disqualification. Could be another moment of genius.
Meanwhile, other members of the UE looking to neutralize Keith Lee. Dominik Dijakovic also struggling to stay on his feet. But look at that one corner where now Ciampa has joined Adam Cole.
Oh dear.
Dijakovic's grip. Strong against Strong. Strong goes through the table courtesy of Dijakovic.
Dijakovic bringing the numbers advantage back to Team Ciampa.
And Dijakovic's not done. Oh, but look at O'Reilly looking for the triangle arm. O'Reilly looking to submit Dijakovic.
Oh, this could be the end of the match.
Dijakovic hanging in there.
Good Lord.
The strength of Dijakovic. He put Strong through a table, but O'Reilly.
Oh, no.
He's causing Dijakovic to fade.
That triangle's on tight. Look at the head of
Dijakovic. Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens all the way to the top turnbuckle. Kevin Owens with the front splash, driving O'Reilly through the table.
No way. Watch out.
Oh, my God.
Keith Lee. Bobby Fish and Lee powerbomb! Fish through the table! Remember when Adam Cole brought all the tables into the cage? He will rue that day forever!
And then there was one! Adam Cole, the sole competitor of the Undisputed Era, still in this!
But will he be the sole survivor? What a shot here, Tommaso Ciampa, Adam Cole. It doesn't get more dangerous than this.
Oh, good Lord.
Look at the height of these two competitors.
Oh, my God.
Superiority's one thing. Proving a point is one thing. What the hell is Tommaso Ciampa thinking?
Good Lord.
Oh, Jesus, no.
No way, no
way. Oh, Jesus, no. There are no words. What in the hell did we just see?
I'm stunned, Marl. Top to bottom. What these competitors did in the ring tonight was just unbelievable.
But Nigel, again, Tommaso Ciampa, Adam Cole on the very top of the cage, and Ciampa sent Cole through the table so many feet below.
Just shocking. Had to be a good 20 feet up there, driven through two tables. I mean, you said it right, Moro. I mean, what words are there?
Well, there's one word that describes Team Ciampa, and that one word is victory. But at what cost?
The wreckage, both literally and figuratively.
The type of competition that changes someone forever.
What a match as Team Ciampa took out one by one members of the Undisputed Era.
Take a look at Kevin Owens taking to the sky.
The surprise fourth member of Team Ciampa. The incredible display by Keith Lee. But then, at the very top of the cage, let this speak for itself. Oh my God. The mother of all air raid crashes. How in the hell is Adam Cole going to be able to defend the NXT Championship against Pete Dunne tomorrow at Survivor Series? Please tell me that.
I have no answer. Right now, I just want to stand here in stunned silence, in awe of the spectacle we just saw.